Tiffany Lachnidt with the Distinctive Group at Keller Williams Premier. Thank you so much for stopping by my video blog today. The purpose of this video is to talk about roofs in Colorado Springs and how hard it actually is to be a roof here in this city. We've experienced some very difficult hail and wind storms over the last couple weeks and over the last year. So with me today is Chris Higby with On Top Roofing, and we're going to talk about roofs and what to do with them when you have damage to them. But first, a few notes about the blog. On this screen, you'll notice a place to click to see all homes available for sale in Colorado Springs. And there's also a link if you're interested in finding out how much your home is worth. Feel free to click there and give us your information, and we will get that back to you as soon as we can. If you'd like to get in touch with me, you can reach me by phone at 719-232-1564. And we'll also give you Chris's information here, both on this email and here in a few minutes, he'll give it to you as well. So as you may have heard, we've experienced some significant hail events here in Colorado Springs over the last couple of weeks. So we thought it was really important to come and talk to you about what that means for you as a homeowner and what it means for you if you're considering selling your home. So one of the big questions I have is, why use a local roofer? If you live in Colorado Springs, you probably had a knock on the door or at the very minimum a business card left on your front door. Why not use one of these companies that's just coming by knocking on doors looking for roof inspections?
Well, I think one of the biggest things is when you get a lot of damage like we've seen lately, and you have an insurance claim that's in the dollar figures of $20,000, $25,000, $30,000, it blows me away that someone would just have someone come knock on their door and then turn over such a big contract like that. You wouldn't do that if they're knocking on your door to sell a car in that price range. And I think it's super important that you, as homeowners, do due diligence and do some research and see what is that company, what kind of history do they have, have they been around for a little while. Those are very important things. Look at the Better Business Bureau, check their reviews, and most importantly, like, some of the reviews I value the most are people I work with on a regular basis. You know, we do a lot of work with Challenger Homes, and you know, that is a review that is valuable to me, because it's not just a roofer showing up to your door and saying, hey, here's 10 people that I made happy over my time here. Anybody can do that. You know, we've done a lot of work with you, and you know, our relationship is valuable to me as well. So, you know, do some research on the people you're going to write a contract with, and make sure you're going to be taken care of.
I think that's a big thing is when someone does stop by your house, a lot of times some of these guys that aren't here locally will push you into writing a contract and signing a contract with them. I think that's dangerous. So, you know, roofs seem pretty simple. They're not as difficult as electrical work or plumbing work is, but we usually find the problems when we go to sell the house. Mm-hmm. Is people have a new roof installed, and one of a number of things goes wrong. Sometimes the roofer doesn't pull permits through regional building, which are required, or they pull them and then don't clear them, and then we're having to chase some of that paperwork down after the fact. So we also see vents get missed sometimes. One of the risks we see is that if they don't leave the venting in the roof, then all of a sudden we start having all kinds of problems with mold in the attic too. So having somebody here is local. Chris has been in business Colorado Springs for the last 10 years. I've worked with him for most of those. He's actually doing a roof replacement for me right now. So if you have experienced some hail damage or think you may have some hail damage, what would be the first step for a homeowner to do?
Take advantage of the contractors that are out there. I mean, every one of us that are legit have free inspections on our vehicles. Take advantage of that. Let a roofing contractor come up, inspect your roof for you. You don't have to get up there, but people are willing to do it for you for free. And we do video inspections. That way, when we get down from the roof, we can show our clients the video of what we found, so that you realize that, yeah, it is important to do. Because there's a lot of times standing down on the ground, looking up on your roof, it doesn't look so bad until you get up there.
Yeah. So one of the questions I have is, how fast is it? Does it take a long time to get people out to take a look at roofs, or how quick can you get somebody out to do an inspection for you?
You know, it depends on how things are. You know, the last month has been absolutely crazy, but typically, you know, if you call our office, we can get somebody out within a day or so.
Okay, great. Well, I'll tell you, some of the advantages to using, to having your roof checked out before you list your house is, if you're thinking about selling, sometimes it's taking some time to get some of these done, because I'm sure you guys just got completely overloaded with people. Some of the hail damage was pretty extensive. What are some of the things you saw down the fountain?
Oh, wow, we've seen, that's very extensive damage. It was a catastrophic storm We had 3-inch hailstones that I saw had gone all the way through the roof and through ceilings and into people's living rooms. So I had one house that had 38 of those.
Yeah, it's pretty devastating down there right now.
Yeah, absolutely crazy.
So call insurance company first, call roofer first. What's the priority there?
You know, it depends on the scenario. Obviously, if you've got a hailstone sitting in your front living room, you probably are good calling an insurance claim in. Otherwise, I'd highly recommend calling and getting a roofing inspector to come out and take a look at it first. That way, if you don't have damage, and I've seen a lot of times where next door neighbor has damage and you don't. And you know, if you don't have damage, you don't want to call in a claim. So let us come take a look at it. That way we can tell you and give you our opinion whether or not you should call in a claim.
Another advantage of Chris is that he'll actually meet the adjuster to make sure that he works with that adjuster to get you the amount you really need to get covered. I think that's one of the challenges we've also seen with some of this is that insurance companies are also shorthanded. So they're bringing in some outside adjusters that may not sometimes do quite as good a job as the regular adjusters do. So having a good quality insurance company, they can work directly with Chris. I'm doing a roof replacement right now and I never even had to look at the house. He went over and it's a rental property, so he went over, inspected it, called the insurance company. He met the adjuster from the insurance company, and the next thing I knew, the check was coming. So really good advantage. Now, let's talk older roofs. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we have sellers and homeowners that are praying for hail damage because they want that insurance company to cover it. What happens as roofs start to age?
Well, a lot of times you'll see the shingles themselves deteriorate and crack. There's a lot of, oddly enough, you know, with our environment here in Colorado Springs, we have hailstorms, and it seems like every area gets hit every 3 to 5 years. But there's still a lot of roofs out there that I'm seeing that have a lot of deteriorated shingles that are just cracked over the years. I'm also seeing the boots around pipe jacks that are cracked and deteriorated and let water in, which obviously causes a lot of problems.
Okay. In our climate, what do you think is the average span of a roof?
I think that the hailstorms are actually taking out roofs quicker than they will last. But roofs typically last about 25 to 50 years, depending on the type of shingle you use.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Some of our older roofs here seem like they won't dent.
Mm-hmm. It's true.
Old. They get harder and harder. Kind of like people, I guess.
Yeah, there's a lot of factors to that, but yeah.
Well, great. Well, Chris, thank you so much for stopping by today. Really informative information. We appreciate it. If our database wants to get in touch with you, how do they reach you?
You can reach our company, On Top Roofing and Restoration. Our office number is 719-896-2533, located right here in the Colorado Springs. You can also check us out on the web, www.ontoproof.com.
And you're also welcome to reach out to me. Chances are if you have some hail damage with your roof, you may also need some other repairs as well. We have an extensive vendor list. We do vet our people. We don't just put anybody on there. We've done a lot of business with Chris, which is one of the reasons we like to put him in front of you, is to make sure you're taken care of. So thank you so much for stopping by today. Please feel free to reach out if you need anything at all.